Hello again team, it's Jess or JashiiCorrin and welcome back for another video. Today I am setting up a new long-term collections bullet journal and I'm doing this in an Archer & Olive A5. This is the journal that came as part of the Valentine's Day box and although I'm not usually a big fan of red, I absolutely love the cover of this journal. I think that the little swan in gold is super cute and I figured that this one would be a good journal to set up my long-term collections in. If you're not familiar with the Archer & Olive journals, they are 160 GSM bright white paper. Each of the journals comes with an elastic closure and a pen loop. Not that I'm gonna really need the pen loop because this journal is not going to be leaving my house. My long-term collections journal is very much more of a reference book than it is like scheduling, to-do list kind of thing. But without further ado, let's get to setting it up. As you can see, I'm starting off by going in with a Tombow jaw brush marker to write out the headers for this page. To make it so that all of the pages in this journal looked a little more cohesive than the last one I had, I decided to use the same header style for each of them. I knew that I didn't want to stick to a full journal color palette. That was going to be a little bit more effort than it was worth, just trying to find a color palette that I wouldn't get sick of using. But something that kind of bothered me from my last long-term collections bullet journal was that the pages didn't really seem to work together well. Having this kind of fun lettering style that's a mix of all caps and lowercase is something that I haven't actually done previously, but I like that it gives me flexibility in my headers on different pages while still making these layouts cohesive. You'll see as we go though, I use different colors for each layout, but they still work well together because of that common element. On this title page though, I'm just writing in some prompts for myself to think about when I go to make a new long-term collection. Another issue that I had from my previous collection bullet journals is that I've ended up putting in spreads and layouts that don't really fit with my intentions for the journal as a whole. My long-term collections journal is supposed to be a space for collections that are going to last longer than the life of one of my day-to-day bullet journals. So things like reference materials, swatch pages, long-term trackers, things that I'm essentially going to want to reference in years to come. I also included a start date just for reference, and then after this it was over the page and on to setting up my index. Now, I don't normally use an index, especially not in my day-to-day bullet journal, and in my last long-term collections bullet journal, I very much only put an index in because the journal I was using had a pre-printed one. With that said though, I did also find that in my last collections journal, I referenced the index a lot more than I thought I was going to. In my everyday journal, it's obviously a bit more chronological, so knowing what I've put where is fairly straightforward. In this journal though, the collections that I'm going to be adding will essentially be added whenever I feel like making them. So no real rhyme or reason as to the order that they go in. With the exception of my swatch pages, which will all be at the back. Of course, the Archer & Olive doesn't have numbered pages, so I will be adding those in myself, but I'm going to be adding those as I go, rather than all at once. Just in case I have to stick pages together at any point, or something like that. As you can see though, we're now onto a space for my collection ideas. I really enjoyed having this one in my last collections journal, so I wanted to make sure I had it in this one too. I also valued having this one towards the front, just as I referenced it any time I felt like setting up a new collection. While in my last collections bujo, I had this over a full spread, I felt that I only really needed one page for it this time. You can see I also transferred some of the ideas that I had in my last journal over into this one too. The majority of the rest of the spreads that I set up in this video though, I have populated off camera. On the other side of the spread, I'm setting up another one of my most valuable collections, which is a space to record any bullet journal theme ideas. I find it really handy to have a space for this so that anytime I'm setting up a new month, I can come to this list and see all of the themes that I've wanted to do previously. It's really good to have a space like this handy so that anytime you're scrolling through Instagram, Pinterest, all that jazz, if you come across a theme that looks really cool, you can note it down here and then all of those ideas are in the one space. Flipping over though, we have two collections that I actually haven't set up previously, and that's a space to record birthdays and a space to record annual holidays. Each of these I'm splitting up so there's a box for each month of the year that I can then denote with the month's initial. When I come to record the birthdays and holidays though, I'll just put them into the relevant box, making sure to note which day of the month it occurs on. Obviously, some holidays I won't be able to record in here, as they aren't on the same day each year, so for instance Easter, but I do have a small space at the top of the holidays page to note down holidays that are like that. Another common element that I'm putting on a good chunk of the pages in this bullet journal are the simple rounded corner borders. I've done these in a lighter shade for any page's header, so for instance, bright orange header, light orange border. Similar to my last long-term collections bullet journal, I wanted to make the setup of these pages quite straightforward, so no complicated designs or doodles. One of the issues that I found with my first long-term collections journal was that when I started making the page designs a little more complicated and a little more decorative, I then felt like I had to continue with that. Like each new page had to kind of live up to the design elements of the last one. Of course, over time, this made me less and less inclined to actually get into the journal, which isn't really an ideal outcome. So for this one, I'm keeping everything simple and straightforward, so I don't feel I have to live up to a certain level of decoration. On this spread though, you can see I'm setting up my Apocalist, or list of things that I want to achieve before the apocalypse. This is essentially just another name for a bucket list, but one that I think is a little bit more fun. The idea for this one came from Mistral Spirit here on YouTube, and I'm really looking forward to transferring my Apocalist items from my old list over to this one. If you had an Apocalist though, what kind of things would you include? What are some of the things that you want to do or achieve before the apocalypse happens? Flipping over though, you can see that I already have half of this spread set up with a list of ideas of things to include on a weekly layout. On the other side, here I'm transferring in my collection of layouts to include in a monthly setup. Both of these lists I do have as printable versions, links to which can be found in the description box below. Down there, I've also listed out any of the materials I've used in this setup, as well as other relevant videos that would be worth checking out if you hadn't already. In particular, that includes the video in which I actually set up the page that we have on the right, and my video of 50 ideas of layouts to include in a monthly setup, which relates to the page I'm filling in at the moment. At the moment, this is the most filled in spread that I have in my long-term collections journal, but now we're over the page and into a series of spreads that I know are going to get a lot of use. And these are all the ones related to media consumption. So TV shows to watch, movies to watch, books to read, games to play, and skills to learn. I decided to set these ones up as a bunch of Dutch doors with little tabs, so I could write the title for each page on those tabs. This gave me extra space on each of the pages to write down all of those things. For the TV show tracker that I'm setting up here, the space on the right of each page is for recording how many seasons of the TV show I've watched. So a little box for each season. As there might be some shows I want to watch that have more than 12 seasons, I haven't ruled all of the horizontal lines in just yet. But I did put in some to show you what this is going to look like when it's finished. Here you can see I'm cutting out the Dutch door, so making use of my scissors, paper trimmer, and corner rounder. To add some visual interest to these pages and to also make the little tabs stand out, I also use some washi tape along the edges of the non-Dutch door pages. So far, this is the only place that I've actually used washi tape in the journal. While in my last collections journal, I was trying to use it on every page. In terms of page design for the movies, books, games, and skill spreads, on each of those I just have a column down the left of each page to record when that thing has been watched, read, etc. For the movie spread, I sectioned each page into two columns, but for the other ones I've just gone with one list per page, in part because I'll likely be recording more movies, but also because the other pages are likely going to have entries that are a bit longer to write. I know I have a bunch of things to transfer over from my old collections journal into these pages, but if you guys have any suggestions of books, movies, TV shows, etc. that you think I should check out, I would love to hear about those. Flipping over though, we are onto my wishlist page and my things to adultify page. These ones I wanted to have together because they are quite related to each other. The way that I differentiate between them is that my wishlist is really for anything that I want, whereas my things I want to adultify page is more for things that I want to get a more updated or adult version of. So for instance, I might want to adultify my bedroom furniture, or get a coffee table, or get better drawer dividers for my cutlery drawer, that kind of stuff. whereas my wish list would be more for things that are probably a little bit more fun. Or at least what's conventionally considered to be fun. So maybe games that I want to buy, stationery that I want to get, electronics, that kind of stuff. Into the back of my journal now, we are setting up a swatch page for my Tombow jewel brush markers. This one is always my most important swatch page, so it gets to go at the very back of my journal, so it's nice and easy to find whenever I need it. Honestly, this ends up being like the most referred to page anytime I have a collections journal. The way I've set this one up is to mimic my storage container for my Tombows. So the same number of boxes across and down that I have in my storage container. For each of the pens, I have a square to fill in with the color of the pen, and then a small box underneath this to write in the pen number. In my previous iteration of this page, I had the color and the pen number in the same space, but I found for the darker pens, it was a little bit harder to actually see what those numbers were. As the swatch itself doesn't take up the entire of the page, I also have space at the top to list out some of my favorite pen colors, just so that I have an easy reference for those ones as well. If you wanted your own version of this swatch page, this is another one that I do have a printable for. So make sure to check out the description box for the link to that one. All of the free printables that I offer from my videos are currently found on my Patreon. You don't have to pay to get these, but it is a convenient space for me to list them. Of course, if you wanted to become a patron, it wouldn't stop you. It's a really nice way to support my channel from as little as $1 per month. But another awesome way you can show your support is just by liking this video and subscribing to my channel. It helps let YouTube know that this is the kind of stuff you want to see, and also might be something that other people want to see too. Your support always means the world to me, team, and I'm really excited that we've recently passed 18,000 subscribers here on YouTube. That is huge! So if you are one of those subscribers, thank you so much, and if you're not, hey, want to join the team? As we have our final flip through though, question of the day for you. What is your most favorite collection that you've ever done in your journal? I love my Apocalist, I love my swatch pages, but my most favorite bullet journal collection that I've ever done would probably have to be from my second bullet journal, where I made a spread dedicated to my Myers-Briggs personality type. That one you can see in my flip through video of that journal, but I'd love to know what collections you guys have made that you've enjoyed. As always, team, thank you for watching. If you liked today's video, please do make sure to give it a big thumbs up, and be sure to subscribe to my channel for more on planning, productivity, and personal development. Until next time, bye!